Yo, what's up my brother, what's up my sister, this is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. In this particular tutorial, I'm going to show you how to remove pimples in an image using the best way that is non-destructive. Ready? If you've not yet subscribed to this channel, come on, subscribe right now. Let's dive into this. Now, this picture was taken by a friend of mine called Derek of Drimax Photography. I'll leave the link of his channel in the description below. And he asked me to give it my own touch. Now, we're going to use a technique called frequency seperation. How do we do this? Basically, what this does, it helps gives us the ability to work on textures of an image alone and the colors of an image alone. So how do we do this? So we come here onto the layers panel I just pulled, and then if it is not there actually on your window, you just come here onto window and just click on to layers, you know, come, then you click on to layers, it will definitely show up. So what you're going to do, you just come duplicate this layer twice, tip like that, and then you rename the bottom layer as tones to mean color. Then we'll name this upper layer as texture, just like that. And then you're going to come here, we're going to unsee this one, the texture layer, and then you come into filter, you say blur, say Gaussian blur, and then we come and blur out. Now here is the thing, this is where I need your maximum attention. Now every kind of texture that we want to maintain in the final output is going to be blurred out. Now let me see. Now I love the texture of her skin around this particular area. I love these pores, so I'm going to make sure that in this particular blur all these pores are not seen, because this is my favorite part of the skin where I'm seeing her pores. She has a very nice textured skin, so I'm just going to come and blur it out just like that. I think a 6 is okay, it's not really a big image for 7 point. Yeah, this is okay for me. Then I'll just come here, okay, another tip, when you're blurring out, make sure you are not, you don't do a little blur that is going to make the final image too smooth, and don't make the blur too much that is going to make the final image too textured, right? It has to be somewhere in between. You blur out in such a way that you still see the facial features and understand that these are eyes, these are things, but again, the skin has to appear a bit smoothed out in the first blur, because this is what determines what the kind of image you're going to get in the final output. So we come make the texture layer visible, select it, and then we come and say image, apply image, we come here and choose the tonal layer, and we are going to subtract the texture that we blurred out and transfer it all onto this upper layer. How do we do that? We still come here and say subtract, make the scale 2, make the offset 128, and then you say okay, leave the rest as they are and say okay. So the next thing we're going to come do here, we're going to come and say linear light. So basically we have two images on this particular layer. Let me just put this in a group like that, and then I'll rename them frequency. Now we have two images. We have this image that we've put in this group and another image here. The difference between the image below in the background layer and the image that is in the frequency layer here is that this image is all together, but this particular image has been segmented in two different parts, where each part of the image has been put onto its own layer. The textures are on their own layer and the tones are on their own layer, right? Great. Let me just show you how we're going to remove pimples. Now, first of all, you're going to create a black and white help layer to bring the pimples all at the top. How do you do that? You just come here onto the adjustment layers and just say black and white. And then what you're going to do, you're going to come and crush the reds so that all the pimples get on top. That's how we're going to do. See how the pimples get on top? Awesome. We shall just pull that at the top right there. And then we are going to come here. And then this is just the help layer. Its intention is to help us bring the pimples actually way closer, actually more visible. It makes the pimples more visible. So what do I do? I'm just going to come and use the clone stamp. Yeah, so you just come and increase the hardness of the clone stamp, and then you press Alt from that particular, from a place that is closer, and then you click on the next one. Basically, you see the clone stamp just pests texture from a close by area and puts it in that particular area. But make sure you press Alt as you click on your keyboard for those awesome results. You alt click. I think you can hear the clicks of a mouse really. I've done this for so long, so it somehow comes in handy. If you're a beginner, definitely with experience you're also going to, you know, to become super fast, you know. See all these. So but you make sure you at least remove, so that you don't remove what we call birthmarks. Yeah, with all these white dots, all these. Because the spot healing was leaving marks behind, and it wasn't giving me the actual textures that I was looking for really. And at the end of the day, I want her skin to look as normal as can be. You know, I was watching a video somewhere and somebody was describing retouching like being a plastic surgeon, whereby nobody has to know that you ever did plastic surgery. They just have to look at you and say, wow, she's beautiful, you know, without ever knowing that you were retouched. So that is what we are trying to get. Yeah, so basically it is what it is, like that. Remove all this stuff. All that. All this. I mean, these crosshairs, we do remove all that stuff. Man, it takes really some time to get the best, but man, at the end of the day, the results are worth it. Look at it as you being scalped. Now, this hairline, man, bothers me a lot. I'll just come and clone it out so that I get a seamless hairline. You know, the wigs usually make it look too, you know. Okay, now I have a full video on how to edit hair. I'm going to leave the link up there so that I show you how to remove all these crosshairs and all that, but we're not going to do that in this particular video. This one is only about skin texture. Okay, let us remove this and see what we have. Oh my god, look at this. See how we've got rid of all the pimples. Oh, there is something here that we couldn't get our eyes on between the black and white. I mean, see, we have got rid of all the pimples. Let me show you the before. Now, that's the before and that's the after. I mean, how crazy is that, you know? So what we're going to do next, we're going to now work on the skin tones of this particular image. We're going to use the lasso tool, and then we come and put it at around 18. in feather, because we don't want the effects of the Gaussian blur to show all over. That's why we feather it, so that it blends in into the whole effect. So what do we do here? You just come, select over here. Filter, blur, Gaussian blur. So I'll just put it at zero again, and then I'll just come and blur it out. Don't take it overboard to a level that it gets flat. No, you don't want that. So you want it to do it in such a way that you still maintain these contours, the depressions, the, you know, and make sure the highlights remain showing, the lights of the image, just like, not so much. That is too much for me. That is good for me. So I'll just come repeat the same thing by pressing Control F, or if you're using a brand new version of Photoshop, it is usually Control Alt or Command Option F, like that. And then I repeat the same pattern. Okay, now this is too much for me. I still love seeing this depression here, you know, so that she doesn't look flat. So I'm just going to create its own Gaussian blur here for this particular zone, so that I don't take it overboard, really. I still want to have those depressions, and that is too much, man. I still want those depressions in. I still come. Now I come onto this particular part of the eye. Press Ctrl F. Over the forehead, filter, blur, Gaussian blur. This really takes a little bit of time, but the results are worth it. Instead of using one Gaussian blur for the complete face, it's always much better. You use different Gaussian blurs depending on the light and depending on how much texture in that particular image is. If you use the same Gaussian blur, somebody ends up having a flat kind of look in the whole image, and that's not what we want, you know. You want to have an image that looks real, that looks believable, not too overly done. Yeah, okay. There, like that. Right there. Filter, blur, Gaussian blur. I mean, all these you remove. You've basically worked and removed the pimples from this image. It's that simple, man. Not as hard as... Now, in my other tutorials, definitely I'll show you how to... Then I'll come here. So now you make sure when you're doing this, the nose is not, doesn't come off as flat. So in my opinion, that is really how you edit pimples. That's how you remove pimples. Let us look at the before and after. That's the before. That's the after. That's the before. That's the after. And when you look at this, we've not flattened her face out. We have just only worked onto the pimples and toned her skin down without taking away the depressions and contours out of her face. That's that for today, guys. I hope to see you in my next tutorial. If you've not yet subscribed to this channel, come on, subscribe right now. And I'll see you in my next tutorial. And adios.